Hello again. Don't know about somewhere in the East Midlands. It's that hot today. It feels like I'm somewhere in the Caribbean. Talking of the Caribbean, I could just eat a cold, ice-chilled mango juice. No ice around here though. My name's Richard, I am the Beery Boater, and we're going to continue where we left off with the side hatches. And then also in this episode, not particularly in this order, I'll just refer to my notes. We're going to look at the ceiling battening and how I intend to batten it out, unless I change my mind. I'm going to work on the hatch, the surround for the stern hatch, and then also put the stern battening on, which will go either side of the stern hatch. The contact adhesive I'm using is a no-nonsense one from Screwfix. It looks and smells very, very similar to Evo stick, but obviously I can't say that it's Evo stick because I don't really know. So it's just a matter of pouring it on, spreading it, and then waiting. Don't put too much on because I'm going to have to get it off. Right, it's on, so I'm just going to spread it about with a bit of scrap wood. I used to use this contact adhesive a lot when I was kitchen fitting in a previous life. I was putting the edging on worktops. I'd use this contact adhesive, and then within a few minutes I'd get a file or a laminate cutter and cut the edge down. And then you get a really nice smooth surface on the edge of the on the edge of the laminate. I mean, the alternatives would have been to use those metal edging strips. Nothing wrong with that, but customers did occasionally ask for the actual formica. It's particularly useful when you're doing breakfast bars. It just finished the edge off nice. I don't know what this reminds you of, but it reminds me of something that comes out your nose when you've got a cold. Anyway, got that contact adhesive on there. And then I'm going to spread it on the door. Right, so those two are covered. Just need to let it go tacky. I mean, they recommend 10 to 20 minutes, but I usually leave it about 10. Around the edge, I'm using grip fill. Again, this is a glue, but it's also a filler, so it'll really adhere to the edge of those doors. Don't need it all the way, just intermittent will be fine, because it's going to squash out, remember. move it onto the edge. I'll probably put some screws in the side as well, although to be honest that really is going to be overkill. Right, let that go off. Right, now magic. Drop that in there and let's start clamping it up. These are just sort of standard G clamps. The thread bit's made of steel and the actual G is cast iron, so you can get quite a good grip, quite a lot of pressure on these. I think these are around about 2000, is it NFs, whatever the unit of pressure is. So it's pretty pretty sort of sturdy. I'm going to do these one at a time because I've only got five G clamps. I'm using four of them on here and I'll leave this on. The contact adhesive is literally that. It's literally a few minutes, but I'm down here, so I'll leave these on for, well, I don't know, maybe an hour, whatever. I want a cup of tea, biscuit, and get on with something else, and then can hang these. Problem is, it's going to rain in a bit. I need to get both. I've already got one door back on, so I need to get both of these on. But I've also got to do some other. Put some other woodwork on the door and on the actual boat so I can fix some bolts on. But I might just put, depending on the time, I might just put those temporarily on here, because you won't see the temporary bolt holes on here because there'll be some wood going on the top of it anyway. Right, let's get a cup of tea while that goes off. Right, the doors are on. So what I'm going to do now is to install some temporary bolts, which will just go on like that, top and the bottom. And then eventually I'm going to pack that top bit out with something like this. I'm not sure of the shape yet, and then the bolt will actually come out quite a bit, just to make a feature of the door. But what I want to do for now is just to make it secure and safe. Right, there's one bolt fixed. This is a little bit difficult to show you because I'm trying to do everything with one hand. So what I've done, I've used that piece of wood as a spacer, so I know how far the bolt's coming along. So I'll do the same there. Okay. And then when I've got the bolt on, let's say it was there, all I'm going to do, if I can do this, can't really do it. Let me show you. All I'm going to do is to centre punch where the holes are, and I'm going to hand screw the screws in. These have got a special thread on, they're security screws, so once they're in, they're pretty difficult to get out. Like I say, I will be moving these bolts at a later stage, but this is what I'm doing for now. It'll be the same top and bottom, so let's do that and then we'll come back. Right, we've got the bolts on, as you can see. Probably put another one on the top right, but the left hand door is the one with the outside lip, so that's absolutely solid now. That'll do me for now until I actually do the get the wall panels on, and then I'll probably change that that formation. Right, I've started to batten out the two sides of the stern wall, if you like, the bulkhead. First of all, I put horizontal in here, grip filled behind it, and then just screwed it into place. Probably put one more screw in the middle here. Grip fill will really hold this, and then I'm going to continue likewise around the side, along the top, and then down there, both sides. I'll continue with that each side, and then we'll come back. Screws I'm using are, you might have seen them before, turbo silver number fours, 40 millimeter long single thread. Don't need to pre-drill them, because they'll all go straight into this this battening. There we go. So that's now in position. This is in position. The vertical coming down here, I'll be taking the all my measurements from this surround, this hatch or door surround, because I know they're absolutely perfect with the when the builder did them. Some of the battening might not be perfect, so that's why I'm just rechecking. So the vertical one, another bit of 2x1, be buttered straight along, straight up to here. Need to know that angle. I could just put it flat, to be honest, which would look something like this. Won't really matter because it's been covered anyway, but I'll just show you how I do get the angle. I'm using a beveled miter, so just hold that against your straight edge, adjust it, and then that's the angle that I need. So I've got my length of wood. This length of wood, cut it maybe half an inch oversize, because I want to cut the angle bit, or mark the angle bit first, and then once the angle's cut, it's a lot easier to do the horizontal. Just mark it and then put that on the saw, and I'll just do that by eye on the miter saw. And it's just a matter of pushing that as far as it will go at the top, and then marking that down here. We're not doing any precision woodwork here. Just mark it, then I'll cut that, and that should drop straight in. So we've cut it. I'll just offer this up. So it's pushed all the way up the top. Now we'll fix that in place, and then onto here will be the 9mm
ply, which will drop all the way down. In fact, I might just do it halfway actually, because I'm probably not going to need to remove this panel again. No, I don't think I am. There's not going to be anything on the outer side of here, unless I decide to put a step on the outside to get onto the roof. I don't really need one because you can jump onto the gas locker. Even if I did that, if I'm using self-tapping bolts, I'm never going to need to remove this panel again. But anyway, we'll see when we come to it. There we go, job done. And now I'll repeat the same on the other side. And another small, tedious, but important job completed. Right, time for a cup of tea. I've also put these two panels up because this will be where I'm taking the measurement from the stern to get the cross member in, and then we can start battening out and building. Then once I've got this cross member in, I'm going to box in the side hatch. It's watertight at the moment, but it's not draft proof, so when it's nice weather, it can be getting that done. This will be inside this cupboard, so I'm not too worried about these screws. And the reason I've used 9mm ply on here as opposed to 6mm, which I'll be using if I ply the ceiling, is so I've got something solid if I want to screw anything to here. Right, this piece of timber on the hatch has been glued with grip fill. That is solid now, and you'll see that it will be square when I've got the other bit on, if you like. That is bang on to the structure of the boat. So the next bit will be fixed into position on there, so that edge is absolutely perfect, so that is perfect. And I also have to make sure that the area over here, to make sure that that wood is square with that there. Difficult for me to hold it and show you. And also, as well as putting grip fill on here, I put a few 3-pocket holes in here to secure this to that. It would have been nigh impossible to screw through here, through the end, like it would do in a conventional way, because I could have been a few millimetres out then at the end. In fact, I might have been centimetre out. It's very, very difficult to measure. So I'm doing it this way, and then those pocket holes will be covered with the wood plugs and then sanded down. Extremely hot today. can see it's all flush down here. Put some metal filler in there just to cover that up. And you can see the pocket holes on here. So everything is now bang on square. Yep. What, one more to put in here? These screws, 30 mil or inch and a quarter, number sevens, and got a very, very fine thread on them. So that's just taking that up now. Like I said, this will be filled with a piece of dowel and then just sliced off and then blended in with the sander. So the pocket hole jig I'm using is a Trend, and there's full adjustment on here. It'll do two, it's made of aluminium. It'll do two holes at a time, and then you can move these in or out. And the way this works is that you've got a drill with a, let me take the drill out, my the drill bit out of my drill. So you've got a drill with a movable sleeve which is locked with an Allen key. That goes in here, and then that drills through the wood. So when I put my the end of my wood in, it will drill through the end at the appropriate angle for thickness of the wood, so it comes out dead center of this wood. It's very clever how it works. So first of all, I'm going to drill the first two. But before I do that, let's put the drill back in. It will help, won't it? The drill is actually, drill bit's actually in the drill. Excuse my sore throat. It's very dry today, very hot. I think I'm ready for a cup of tea or a beer. So the marking on here I've been doing, I've been putting that couple of mil from the edge. These holes are going to be covered anyway. So I'm just holding that wood, clamped it into place, and then very gently I'm coming out like that. And then same on the other one. Again, just let the drill rest in there. Don't start it drilling until it's in. And then very loosely, without hardly any pressure, and then we've got our pocket holes. I'm going to show you one, the final one, from another angle. So my final one, again I'm just doing it by eye, a couple of millimeters from the start of the curvature. They're going to be plugged anyway, so you won't see the screws. Let's try and do it like that. It's very difficult to do and film at the same time, but let's have a go. So just let the drill sit in there. Make sure you've got your hand on the clamp if the wood's too thick for it to be clamped. Make sure this wood is flat, so it's on the base of here, so it's nice and square. And gently and you'll see all the residue sawdust comes out here, it also comes out the hole at the back just here. That's pocket hole drilling. Well, that was a struggle with one pair of hands. As you can see, everything is nice and square. I can hold the square. Ditto that side. There we go. Job's a good one. Wait for that to go off and then cut that off, that grit fill, and then sand it down, put my dowlings or wooden closures in here, glue those in, a few coats of yacht varnish, job done. It's still nice out here. I think it's about 23, 24 today. A lot of activity down the boatyard today. Everybody's at it. Inside the boat at the moment, it looks a lot more like a workshop every day. In fact, just before I sign off with this video, I'll just take you through again and tell you what's happening. At the moment, I'm not in a position to put any masking tape or anything down on the floor to show you the separate areas, and I probably won't be doing that until I get to the until I get to the bathroom. So this is the front of the boat, or the bow. There will be the steps here. It's a reverse layout, so the bedroom will be at the pointy end. As you come in, there'll be a wardrobe each side, 2 foot wardrobe. The bed, 4 foot wide bed, will start about here, full size in length, 6 foot three mattress, and that will be on the starboard side. So there'll be a a gangway down here, a couple of feet. And then here will be the entrance to the open plan bathroom. Come in here, sink on the right hand side, shower cubicle in that corner, toilet, WC here, and then the exit the exit from the bathroom will be on the left. So it's what we call a walk-through bathroom. Then we'll be into the salon area, or the lounge. And if I decide to have a dinette of any description, that will be underneath the side hatch here. And the kitchen will start about here, which is 7 foot from here to here, which will be a cupboard, and that will be my electrics cupboard, and then again kitchen worktop down here. I've got an idea what I want to do with this. In fact, I do have some plans somewhere. I saved them, put them onto a USB stick, and me like a numpty, I'm not sure where it is, somewhere in the house. Should have saved them onto the hard drive on the computer as well. But anyway, that's roughly the layout. I may well put another cabinet, 2 foot wardrobe, between the shower and the bottom of the bed, so there's space for a washing machine in there, but I'm not sure yet. We shall see. It's a suck it and see job, really, like I mentioned in an earlier vlog. I've got an idea in my mind what I want and the styles of each area, but I keep looking at different images and videos of other narrow boats and thinking, oh yeah, I like that, I like that. I've actually put together a scrapbook of images in PDF format of everything that I like, and the final result will be based on that. Right then, I think that's it for this vlog. We'll wrap it up a bit. I do apologise if the vlogs have not been as regular as I would have liked them to have been. I'm working on my own on this boat. I'm also doing other things as well as this boat project, so it's not a clear-cut run as some of the other boat tubers. But hopefully in a few weeks' time I'll be sort of working at least the weekends on the boat every weekend, and I'll be updating you there and then. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you're not subscribed, please do so, and then you'll be notified when I release a new video. If you like it, press the or hit the thumbs up button. If you don't, hit the thumbs down. I'm not bothered. Right, see you soon. Take care.